The philosophical foundation of Suzuki's educational approach is closely related to some aspects of the philosophy of nature, which is based on the processes that take place in nature and in the entire creation. Based on these discoveries, Suzuki formed his personal ideas about the meaning and the purpose of life. He transferred his insights to pedagogy and art. On this foundation, he developed his own teaching method. Its aim is to give teachers, parents, and children the possibility to experience their own development process on a daily basis. Suzuki grew up as a Buddhist and later, while studying in Germany, converted to the Catholic faith. However, in his heart of hearts, he felt bound neither to Western nor to Eastern tradition. His life, according to rigid rules of faith and religious dogmas, did not correspond to his personality. He simply wanted to adapt himself to the laws of creation, to feel part of it, and to live his life in accordance with it. Suzuki very often spoke of the life force which we receive from nature. He considered it to be the origin of all life. Suzuki describes in his book, Nurtured by Love, what man may learn from nature. He tells us to lead our lives as taught by Mother Nature. Taking a fruit tree as an example, he describes the wonderful course of natural development from a bud to the ripe fruit.
A living tree brings forth buds. On each branch blooms lovely flowers. It is the splendid course of nature. Man, I believe, should follow Mother Nature and bring forth fruit.
Let us sum up again his main thoughts. The life force is a gift of nature. If man accepts that he is a part of creation and not its center, he too can use the life force. The force that is felt everywhere in creation. Man has the possibility to learn from nature the correct way of living. He will develop abilities and talents, like a tree its buds, and add joy and beauty to life, like the blossoms on the tree. The goal is to develop personality and talents to the point where man becomes a useful part of creation, like the tree that bears fruit. If man follows this path, he will find many more helpful and satisfying experiences on the way. Children need guidance. This can best be provided by able, caring, and concerned adults. Parents may arrange the surroundings of a child in such a way that the child will regularly receive stimulation by those values which the parents wish to pass on to their child. Here are some examples from different areas of life. Young children learn many things through observation and imitation, but also through trial and error and consistent involvement in everyday family tasks. With childlike confidence, even young children can feel the values that parents have chosen as guiding principles for their own lives.
Starting children off with the fun of playing a game, letting their spirit of fun lead them in the right direction, is the way all education of children should be started. This is the art of education at its best. The thing that matters is the result, that the child acquires the skill. If you are formal and strict, and have a "this is education" attitude, you will immediately warp the child. First, you must educate the mind, then inculcate the skill. This is a correct, natural method.
It is in this context that Suzuki mentioned again and again this principle of education: guide, but not pull. Among animals, we find this parental behavior everywhere, just like with the duck family here. Mother duck has most likely not read a manual of education. There are many families where parents do not pay enough attention to the needs of their children. They are more concerned with their own social or professional lives. In such cases, Suzuki regretfully states, many children have been ignored and their talent is lost. Only that which is cultivated can also develop. The life experiences of many generations teach us that developmental processes cannot be skipped over. Nature shows us the process of sowing and reaping, which applies to almost all parts of creation. This natural law is valid also for us as human beings, and in particular for the education of our children. The English author Charles Reed describes the possible effects.
Which seed do you want to sow? Sow an idea and you reap an act. Sow an act and you reap a habit. Sow a habit and you reap a character. Sow a character and you reap a destiny. Charles Reed.